Hello my dear friends, in this video we will going to learn conservation of mass principle. That means what is the conservation of mass, like the conservation of energy for a open system. See, first of all, what is the principle of a conservation of mass for a system? That means the net mass transfer, the net mass transfer to, if this is your control volume system, if this is your control volume system, and this is our control surface, right? So this is our control surface. The boundary of a control volume is called control surface. And if there is a in to the mass, and somewhere there is exit to the mass, exit from out, right? Out of the mass, right? Out from the control volume. So the conservation of mass for a control volume says that the net mass transfer to or from a control volume during a time interval delta t. That means what is the net mass transferring to or from a control volume during a time interval delta t is equal to the net change, that means increase or decrease, in the total mass within the control volume during time delta t. That is, what is that? Total mass entering the control volume during delta t. This is your total mass in, that means summation of all the mass which is in, minus total mass leaving the control volume during delta t is equal to the net change of mass within the control volume during delta t. That means net inflow minus net outflow, this is your inflow minus net outflow, is equal to net change of mass within the control volume. This is the within the control volume, and this is your boundary, cross the boundary. That means what is that? The mass entering the control volume minus mass outflow from the control volume is equal to net change of a mass within the control volume. This is precisely a conservation of mass, right? Okay, this is in kilojoule, kg. Now, what is that MCV? Is the change in the mass of the control volume during the process, right? It can also be expressed on the rate basis. That means rate form. What is that? The rate of mass enter to the control volume minus rate of mass which is out from the control volume is equal to dmcv by dt. Here it is not cut. Why? Because this is the property. That means it is a within the control volume. It is not a cross, but this is a cross. If you take d, तो हियर वी कट मार्क ओवर डी. वाई? बिकॉज दिस इज योर क्रॉस द बाउंड्री. दैट मीन्स वॉट इज द मास इन, दैट मीन्स क्रॉस थ्रू ए बाउंड्री विच इज इन टू द कंट्रोल वॉल्यूम, एंड दिस इज आउट. दैट मीन्स इट क्रॉस द बाउंड्री एंड इट लीव्स, विच इज इक्वल टू वॉट इज द मास एक्युमुलेटेड विद इन द कंट्रोल वॉल्यूम, राइट? एंड दिस इज योर केजी पर सेकेंड, किलो जूल पर सेकेंड. ओके, नाउ वॉट इज दैट? दिस इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड, दैट मीन्स दिस टू इक्वेशन ऑल्सो कॉल्ड मास बैलेंस. मास बैलेंस, राइट, ऑफ एनी कंट्रोल वॉल्यूम, ऑफ एनी कंट्रोल वॉल्यूम. दैट मीन्स इट आइदर कंट्रोल वॉल्यूम मूविंग, आइदर कंट्रोल वॉल्यूम स्टेशनरी, आइदर कंट्रोल वॉल्यूम एक्सपेंडिंग, आइदर कंट्रोल वॉल्यूम कॉन्ट्रैक्टिंग, अंडरगोइंग एनी कंट्रोल वॉल्यूम एंड एनी काइंड ऑफ प्रोसेस. एनी काइंड ऑफ प्रोसेस, एनी कंट्रोल वॉल्यूम, दैट मीन्स ओके. नाउ वॉट इज दैट डी एम सी वी बाई डी टी? What is that dmcv by dt? That means total mass within the control volume. Now, number A, total mass within the control volume. That means the total mass is what? mcv. The total mass mcv is equal to what? All summation of all the mass within the control volume is what? Rho into change in volume, right? Elemental change. So this is your total mass within the control volume. If it is in rate basis, so how can you write that? dmCv by dt is equal to 1 by dt integration of a control volume rho dv. This is your rate of change of a mass within the control volume, right? Let's suppose this is our control volume, this is our control volume, and this is our control surface, and take this is our control surface. Okay, this is our control surface. So this is our control surface. Okay, if you take any elemental area over the control surface, this is your elemental area over which the mass will flow in or out. So this is your direction of area which is perpendicular to that area, and this is our velocity in any direction. This is our velocity. So the angle between that is theta. We take angle between that is theta. This is dA. dA is the area over a control surface, elemental area, right? If you take this much of amount of mass, you take elemental mass. This is our elemental mass. Okay, this is your elemental mass of volume dV and mass dm. This is the mass, elemental mass of a control volume, right? So what is that? So if you take vn, this is your direction of vn, this is your direction of vn, vn. So if you take vn is what? V cos theta, right? And what is the V cos theta? वी वैक्टर इन टू एन वैक्टर यूनिट वैक्टर, सो दिस योर वी एन, राइट? सो वी डॉट एन, इफ देर आर टू थिंग वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, इफ इन दिस केस इफ आउटफ्लो, आउट फ्लो, इफ द फ्लो इज आउट, सो इफ द फ्लो इज आउट, सो थीटा, थीटा इज लेस देन 90 डिग्री, थीटा इज लेस देन 90 डिग्री, फ्लो इज आउट, एंड इफ द फ्लो इज इन, इन फ्लो, सो वॉट इज थीटा, थीटा इज ग्रेटर देन 90 डिग्री. लेट सपोज दिस इज योर, दिस योर आउट, लेट सपोज दिस इज योर कंट्रोल वॉल्यूम, एंड इफ दिस इज योर एरिया, क्रॉस सेक्शन एरिया विच इज आउट, सो दिस इज योर v vector and also in that direction this n vector, so this theta is less than 90 degree, and if this is into the control volume, so this is your n vector and this is your v vector, so in this case theta is greater than 90 degree, so if the flow is out, theta is less than 90 degree, so what is the value of Vn? Positive. If inflow, what is the value of Vn? Negative. Right? So, what is the, so what is the mass flow rate? Dm dot, what is that? Rho Vn dA. And rho, what is the Vn? V cos theta into dA. And what is the V cos theta? Rho V vector dot n vector into dA. This is the elemental mass which is flow to the control volume, to or from the control volume. So what is the net, net mass flow rate? Mass flow rate. What is the net mass flow rate? M dot net. What is the net mass flow rate? The net mass flow rate integration. Or this net mass flow rate is the boundary phenomena. That means it is a control surface. And integration dm dot. So, control surface, what is the dm dot? Rho v vector n vector into dA. So, this is your net mass flow rate. And this net mass flow rate is what? This net mass flow rate is what? Net mass out from the control volume minus net mass into the control volume. So, this is your net mass. So, what is the conservation of mass? What is the conservation of mass? What is the conservation of mass? The conservation of mass is that m dot rate basis in minus m dot out is equal to dm cv by dt. Right? So, dm cv by dt is equal to m dot out minus m dot in, so plus is equal to 0. So what is m dot c, dm cv by dt? What is the dm cv by dt? Dm cv by dt is what? D of dt, control volume, rho into dv, plus what is this? Your net, this is your net mass flow rate, this is your m dot net, and what is the m dot net? This is your control surface, rho v vector n vector into dA. This is equal to 0. So this is also a integral form of conservation of mass. So what is that? What is stated that time rate of change, that means time rate of change of mass within the control volume plus the net mass flow rate through the control surface. This is within the control volume, this is through the control surface, is equal to zero. That means the rate of change of a mass within the control volume plus net mass flow rate through the control surface is equal to zero. That means what is the change of a mass? What is the change, rate of change of a mass within the control volume plus what is the rate of a mass, net flow rate of the mass? That means this is net. Why? Because this is integration and this is your net change, time rate of net change. This is your net change. Net change of a mass within the control volume, net change of the mass within the control volume is equal to net mass flow rate through the control surface is equal to zero, right? That means if you write like that, what is that? If you write like that, that means what is that? Rate of change of mass within the control volume, dT within the control volume, plus net rate of flow, that means over a control surface, rho v vector n vector into dA is equal to zero. So we can write like that d of dt over a control volume rho dv plus what is that? Plus summation of out rho v n vector dA out minus in minus, put a bracket here, minus in rho v vector n vector into dA is equal to zero. So what? This is your magnitude. What is that? D of dt over a control volume rho dv plus summation out rho, this is the v magnitude into dA minus out rho v into dA is equal to zero. So what is that? D of dt within the control volume rho dv plus what is that? This is your in plus summation of all the mass out mass flow rate minus all mass in is equal to zero. Why? Because this is your mass flow rate. So what is that? So what is that? We can write like that dmCv by dt is equal to net mass inflow, rate of mass inflow minus net rate of mass outflow. Why? Because there is a control volume. There is in, this is your in, if this is your out. So what is the mass rate of mass within one? dmCv by dt एंड इफ यू टेक टोटल दैट मीन्स समेशन ऑफ इन मास समेशन ऑफ मास आउट. इफ यू टेक व्हाट इज द इन नेट इन टू द नेट आउट इज इक्वल टू नेट रेट ऑफ चेंज ऑफ मास विद इन द कंट्रोल वॉल्यूम. ओके, सो व्हाट इज द देर आर टू थिंग इज दैट इफ देर इज अ क्लोज सिस्टम दिस इज क्लोज सिस्टम. If this is a closed system, so there is no in, no out. That means summation of in m dot minus summation of out m dot is equal to zero. So what is that? This will zero. This will zero. So what is that? dm cv by dt is equal to 0 for a closed system. For a closed system, if the flow is steady, that means the property of a control volume that means what is the mass in is same mass out. This is for a steady flow, but this is not like that. This is not, this is a mistake, danger mistake. If you not like that, if this is happening, the flow is steady but not a closed system. The closed system, no in, no flow out, no flow in, that means both are zero, and this is mathematically incorrect. So this is not for a closed system. For a closed system, this will zero and this will zero. Not written like that. Mistake. Always, if this is zero, if this m n and this m mass out for steady flow. For steady flow. Okay? So keep in mind. Right? So what is the conservation of mass? The conservation of mass is that rate of change of mass which is into the control volume minus rate of change of mass which is out from the control volume is equal to rate of change of mass within the control volume. Number first. And what is the integral form? Rate of change of mass within the control volume plus net outflow and inflow within the control volume is equal to zero. This is your density. So this is your integral form, right? And this is your differential form. Or if the flow is steady, so what is the mass flow is in is the same mass flow is out. So for steady, dm cv by dt is equal to zero. The flow is steady. If there is a closed system, individually no mass into the system and no mass out from the system. So for that dm cv by dt is equal to zero. So final outcome will same for steady for closed system or for steady flow. But for steady flow, what is the mass is in, same mass will out. But for a closed system, there is no mass in and there is no mass out. Okay, So keep in mind, third, and this is your fourth. Very important. Okay. Thank you.